Hello students, today we will discuss about the types of respiration. On the basis of availability of oxygen, respiration is of three types: aerobic respiration, anaerobic respiration, fermentation. First, we will see the definition of three types of respiration. Then we can easily differentiate between them. First, see aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration is the process of complete oxidative breakdown of glucose to carbon dioxide and water by free oxygen with the formation of ATP. Emphasize these words: complete oxidative breakdown of glucose by free oxygen. So this is the definition of aerobic respiration. Now see the definition of anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration is the process of complete oxidative breakdown of glucose to carbon dioxide and water by bound oxygen with the formation of ATP. So what is the main difference between aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration? Aerobic respiration is occurred by free oxygen. Anaerobic respiration is occurred by bound oxygen. Now see the fermentation. Fermentation is the process of partial oxidative breakdown of glucose to some simpler compounds in absence of oxygen with the formation of ATP. So, aerobic respiration, complete oxidative breakdown by free oxygen. And the products are carbon dioxide and water. Anaerobic respiration, it is also complete oxidative breakdown but by bound oxygen. Products are also carbon dioxide and water. And fermentation, this is partial oxidative breakdown and in absence of oxygen. And in this case, the products are some simpler compounds like lactic acid, alcohol, etc. So these are the basic differences between aerobic, anaerobic respiration and fermentation. Now see, how many ATP are generated during aerobic oxidation of 1 gram mole of glucose? 38 gram mole. You have to remember this unit, 38 gram mole. Next one is, what is RQ, respiratory quotient? The ratio between the volume of CO2 evolved and the O2 consumed. That means CO2 by O2. The ratio is called the respiratory quotient. In case of glucose, it is 1 because 6 CO2 is evolved and 6 O2 is consumed. Now see the overall reactions of three types of respiration. First, aerobic respiration. C6H12O6, that is glucose plus 6H2O plus 6O2 form 6CO2 plus 12H2O plus 686 kilocalorie. See the amount of energy, 686 kilocalorie. Now see anaerobic respiration. Glucose plus 12NO3 nitrate forms 6CO2 carbon dioxide plus 6H2O plus 12NO2 nitrite, and the energy is 50 kilocalorie. See the difference. Here 686 kilocalorie energy is formed. Here only 50 kilocalorie energy is formed. Okay, now see the fermentation. There are two types of fermentation: lactic acid fermentation and alcoholic fermentation. Lactic acid fermentation reaction, glucose forms lactic acid and 36 kilocalorie energy, and alcoholic fermentation, glucose forms ethyl alcohol, carbon dioxide and 50 kilocalorie energy. That means the energy formed in fermentation is almost similar amount of the anaerobic respiration. But in aerobic respiration, the energy is more than the anaerobic and the fermentation. So if we understand the aerobic, anaerobic and fermentation, we can easily differentiate between aerobic, anaerobic respiration, anaerobic fermentation, or the differences among the three, aerobic, anaerobic and fermentation. So this is all about today's class. Thank you.